Good morning to everyone. Now we are going to discuss about object-oriented methodologies. Object-oriented methodologies is the collection of method, models or rules we are going to follow to develop the application. Generally, the methodology is explained as a science of methods. That is, a method is a collection of procedures in which we are going to achieve some of the goal in step-by-step manner. So it's called as a method. There are a lot of methodologies out there. Here we are going to discuss three methodologies, that is Rumbaugh methodology, Jacobson methodology and Booch methodology, because these are the origins of the UML or a unified approach. The UML is a unified modeling language which have a set of notations to design the application. The history of the methodologies. In 1986, the Booch was developed object-oriented design concept. So it's called as the Booch method. This method have a lot of diagrams such as class diagram, object diagram, module diagram, process diagram, etc. With the help of this diagram, we can able to design the application. In 1991, Jim Rumbaugh and a team was developed the OMT at the research lab of General Electric. In 1994, the Jacobson was introduced the concept of use case, which gives the overview of a system. Now, how to consider the OMT technique, that is Rumbaugh methodology. This OMT technique describes the model of analysis, design and implementation. The benefits of this technique. With the help of this technique, we can able to express the details of the objects, attributes and operations. And with the help of this model, we can easily express the functional description with the help of a data flow diagram. And we can easily identify the objects and design the model in a system. So these are the benefits using OMT technique. This OMT technique have four phases, that is analysis phase, system design, detailed design, then implementation phase. So these are the four phases to be used in OMT technique. The analysis phase. Before we are going to develop the application, we can thoroughly understand the system requirements. This to be carried out in the analysis phase. The results of the analysis, object model, dynamic model and functional model. Then system design. Here we specify the structure of the basic architecture of a system. Then detailed design. Here it discusses the detailed information about the objects, that is attributes, operations and the relationship between the objects. Finally, the implementation phase. It is used to develop the application. It supports reusability, extensibility and robust code. So these are the four phases available in OMT technique. This OMT technique also have three different parts, that is the object model, dynamic model and functional model. Object model specifies the structure of the object in a system. It gives the detailed information about the objects, that is object, then purpose of the object, then what are all the attributes to be added in the object and what are all the operations to be performed on each and every object. So these can be clearly mentioned with the help of an object diagram.
Here we are going to draw the object diagram of order management system. So these are all the various notations we are going to use to draw the object diagram or a class diagram. This notation is same for both object diagram and a class diagram. This have three compartments. The first compartment specify the name of the object or a class. Second compartment specify attributes and third compartment specify operations. Now we are going to consider customer object. This customer object C is associated with the number of order object, that is order 1, order 2, order 3. This is the order 1. This is order 2. And this is order 3. Here we are going to specify the association between the customer object and order object with the help of this unidirectional association. This order objects also have attributes. Here we are going to add attributes, that is number of order. For example, number is equal to 20. Here we have to specify the attribute. Number is equal to, that is number of order, is equal to 30. Here the number is equal to 40. So this order object also associated with some special order object. So here we are going to specify the association between the order object and also a special order object. Here also you have to specify the attribute is equal to, for example, 25, and here specify the attribute is equal to 35. So likewise, you are going to draw the object diagram for any application. So this is the example of order management system. It belongs to OMT technique.
And second thing was dynamic model. We specify the dynamic behavior of an object with the help of a state chart diagram.
These are the various notations we are going to use to draw the state chart diagram. So it have two compartments, that is name compartment and the internal transition. The name compartment specify the name of the object or the state, and the internal transition specify the internal activators. Now we are going to draw the state chart diagram for a library application, specifically for a valid member. So this is the start state. Here you have to specify the state, that is check the book availability. Here you have to specify the transition. Here how to specify the member is valid. Here how to specify the internal transition. Here also we have to specify the event, that is book available. The next thing is, if the member is valid, then check the number of books to be issued. Here also you have to specify the transition. Here you have to specify the event. It is member is a valid member. It is a valid member. After that, perform transaction or create transaction. Next, maintain the book issue details. Then update the book status. You have to specify the transition and finally update the number of book issue details. Issued to member. Here also we have to specify the transition. And finally, we have to specify end state.
And then functional model. It describes the process description or the process details of a system and the data movement between the process. So this can be clearly mentioned with the help of a data flow diagram.
It uses several symbols to draw the data flow diagram. That is process, data flow, data store, then external entity. The process specify any function is to be performed. The second thing is data flow. It specify the direction of the data element movement. Then data store, which is used to specify the location of a data. That is, where the data to be stored. Then external entity. It refers to source or destination of a data element. So these are the various symbols we are going to use to draw the data flow diagram. Next, we are going to consider the relationship between object model, dynamic model and functional model. The object model, dynamic model and the functional models are complementary to each and every one. The object model specify the static structure of an object within a system. Generally, the object diagram specify static view of a system. The static view of a system represents the snapshot of a system at a particular moment. And then the dynamic model specify the dynamic behavior of objects in a system. It specify the sequence of operations to be performed on the objects. Then functional model specify the overview of a system, that is what the system should do.
Adoption methodology, it introduces the concept of the use case, where the use cases are the scenarios. With the help of this, we can easily understand the system requirements.
This methodology uses a concept of a use case. These are all the various notations we are going to use to draw the use case diagram. So this use case diagram shows the library application. That is, it gives the overview of a library application. This use case diagram can have two actors, that is library member and then supplier. So what are the activities to be performed by the library member in this sense? So these are all the activities. So these are all the process to be carried out by the library member. That is checking out books, getting an interlibrary loan, doing research, reading books or newspapers. So here the supplier can do the process, that is purchasing supplies. So likewise, we are going to draw the use case diagram for any application which is used to give the overview of a system.
Use case describe any of the following: non-formal text with no clear flow of events, then formal text or a text with a clear flow of events which is easy to read, then formal styles using pseudocode. Then use case description must follow the several information, that is how and when the use case begin and end. Jacobson methodology also include object-oriented software engineering, object-oriented business engineering. The object-oriented software engineering also called as a object tree. Object tree is a method for developing large real-time applications. It have different models or various models such as use case model, analysis object model, domain object model, implementation model, then test model. First one is use case model. It specifies who are all the actors to be involved in application and what are all the process to be carried out by the each and every actor. So these can be clearly mentioned with the help of a use case diagram. And next thing is domain object model. Here the object of the real world are mapped into the domain object model. Then third thing is analysis object model. Here we have to specify the source code and how we are going to carry out the source code. That is how we are going to implement the source code. And then implementation model, it specifies the development of the application. And last one is test model. It specifies the specification, test plan and test report. And then object-oriented business engineering. So this is not the way to develop the application at the enterprise level. It also have the several phases. That's analysis, design, implementation, and then testing phase.